Okay, this tutorial is going to be another one about backgrounds, but it's going to be little tips on how to enhance a background that you've already made. So I have this one. If you'll watch my other story, you'll see a glimpse of the pink watercolor background. All I did was put a gradient and sparkles on it. Of course, if you do this kind of thing and you're like, oh, but I want, any other color theme, just go to desaturate. And then image adjustments levels and go through each one. See, there you go. Now you can add whatever color you want to it, get rid of the gradient, and adjust the colors to however you see fit. Which can be really handy if you find a background you like absolutely love, but it's in a gradient and you don't want the gradient and such, blah blah blah. Anyways, next step. Make a copy of the background and do something like image adjustments, invert, I think that looks pretty awesome. Or, just change the colors around. No, I'm actually going to invert it and leave it on normal. And now you're going to go to the eraser tool. And any brushes you have loaded are automatically loaded into the eraser as well. Really handy tip there. But a couple things I have is like I have this skull, not skull, it's a crown. Just click to erase, and you'll get, your first background showing through. So that can be a really cool effect. Just kind of overlap them a little bit. You might have to click it a couple times because you do have an extra layer on top you're erasing. It might not look quite as decent as it does if you were just using this as a brush. So just keep that in mind and go around, resize the brushes a little bit, make a this like giant Jack Skellington head I'm gonna put over in the corner. That me bear. You can do this with any brush, even the like regular Photoshop brushes, squiggly, squiggly, squiggly. That is an one tip you can do. It can really make a pretty neat looking background. Once you do that, you can go like use some filters, blur it because it'll only blur the top. So the bottom will still be like crystal clear and you can get some interesting effects. Use the filter gallery on the top layer. Go through it, just whatever you think looks nice, like sponge, no, poster edges. Looks really, really cool. And it's a big difference from the background. You could even, lower the opacity of it, depending on the look you want. Go through, different settings, like there we go, color dodge. It went from really dark to looking really awesome bright, Just play around with it. That's just one of my tips. Another tip for rounded or other edges, double click it. Okay, and now go to select all, and over here. In regular Photoshop, you'll have enter quick mask mode. If you don't have that and using elements, you should have like a masking tool that'll have a very similar effect. It's just not done in a button. And what you can see over here is you go to masks. Oh, that's not a mask. The channel. There we go. I got confused. But it's black because everything's highlighted. Everything that's red should be highlighted. Now, what you can do is you can select all again and you say edit stroke with choose white because white will subtract from the selection. I'm going to say inside and how about 20 pixels? There we go. Now you can apply filters to this, a blurred filter, one that I like. I'm gonna blur is actually by 10 pixels. All right, and now you exit quick mask mode, and it has selected that for you. All right, now you just press delete, and you got a nice border. Now you can even go image adjustments invert. That's another way of selecting the inverse, and then you can just like delete that. Let me make another layer. There you go. So now you can, like, really see the effect it has on the edge. And if you want it just transparent, just go to File, Save As, and choose PNG. Say Save, and go to Interlaced. I mean, it might work with none, but I always use Interlace for some reason, and it always ends up fine. Though MySpace might fuck it up a little bit. Another thing you can do about Quick Mask Mode is it basically making a new channel. So if you make a new channel and you want to draw something out, I don't know, when you just use the lasso tool, okay? You can go over here to Load Channel as Selection. And there you go. That's selected. Another, you know, neat little trick in case you don't have Quick Mask Mode, but you do have a channels option. I'm just going to delete that channel for now. Rounded edges is another one that people like. So you go over here to the Eclipse tool, right click, and Rounded Rectangle tool. And I like to use it on to make a path. And, you know, you can pick the radius and such. I'm just going to try to even it out, you know, there. Now you can, like, make selection, you know, feather it or don't feather it. Another thing you can do, if you're like me and it's really, really hard for you to get a good shape, just do what you can to make, you know, a nice rectangle without worrying about the sides too much. And go fill path. Okay. Gotta go over to the pen tool to delete the path. And then image, adjustments, no, edit, free transform. And then you can use this. You can also do this on channels if you want it. It works the same way. But I'm just gonna move this around. There. And now I'm gonna use the wand tool to select it. Delete it, select inverse, and, you know, nice rounded edge. And you do the same thing with the channels, just make that shape in the channels, and make a white square, pull the white square, and just go load channel as selection. And those are just a couple things that I really like about how to make backgrounds. Oh, one more thing. Double click the background layer once you have the checkers. The checkers means that it's transparent and it will turn up transparent online. So if you have a black background, it'll be black. If you have a white background, it'll be white. I like to use like drop shadow or, you know, inner shadow, you know, bevel and emboss. Anything that would drop down, outer glow as well. Let me use a color that you'll see really, really good. There we go, nice bright red. It'll transfer like that. So that can be another handy tip. And that's all the tips I have for now. If you can think of anything else that you want to know, let me know in a message or a comment on this video or my other background tutorial video, and I'll see what I can do.